true, and did. And they hear Potter and Gimo from the early 80s, and he has been a long friend of this cooperation between the National and the corporation.
Just a little bit of correction. The thing is that I'm not vice director, I'm vice director of the International Institute of Energy Policy and Diplomacy, and this institute is part, an integral part of GIMO University. And the university is part of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of the Russian Federation, and our university is in the Guinness Book of Records because we teach 54 foreign languages, so which is a big achievement in itself. And of course, it's a big difficulty, it's a big challenge, but at the same time, we have a competitive advantage because our students can learn in English and also our professors can teach in English. So therefore, this is the reason why we have this lengthy and extremely fruitful cooperation with the University of Norland. Of course, this history of cooperation is not as long as with the STU, but still it is more than 10 years, and we have been running two major double degree programs in the oil and gas sector, and the one is master degree program, and we see students from this program attending this conference, which I'm very glad to see, and also we have another major program, which is MBA program we implement jointly, with support of Statoil and, of course, Norwegian Parliament and other agencies. This is an MBA program with the same name, International Business and Oil and Gas Sector, for Rosneft top-level executives. And I would like to say here that so far we have trained more than 84 top-level officials from Rosneft, and several vice presidents and a lot of general directors from the subsidiaries across Russia. So this is a very fruitful and productive cooperation. And actually, very recently, we changed the name of our WB program. We run together with the university. It used to be International Business and Business and Oil and Gas Sector. Now we added and Development of Energy Resources of the Arctic. So this is, of course, a new challenge. And that means that we are very much interested in training experts for the further development of resources in the Arctic, and that this is a very big and significant important function for the Russian government, and of course, working with Rosneft, Gazprom, and other major oil and gas companies in Russia, we realize what the needs they have in terms of training experts for to be employed later on with these companies. Of course, going along the lines of the previous speaker, we want to have pants, but in our case, we want to have oil. And to deal with oil, we need a lot of governance in the Arctic. So I would like to say a couple of words about perspectives of the development of Arctic energy resources from the viewpoint of how this should be regulated and sort of governance. So, and at the same time, I would like to say big thanks to the BSTU and the Council General of Norway in St. Petersburg for making up this conference. And I'm very much privileged to have this opportunity to speak here. First of all, I'd like to convey best regards and say hello from director of our university and director of our institute. And so therefore, I've just made this introduction just to prove that Russia and we as a university, which represents the Minister of Foreign Affairs of the Russian Federation, we we're very serious about the development of Arctic resources and also about establishing kind of a good and harmonized regulatory regime for doing this. Also, I would like to say a couple of words about our other programs. We have a very good double degree program with St. Andrews University, and recently established a joint Arctic Research Center with them. And we run a double degree program which is called Sustainable Development and Strategic Management in Energy. And of course, a lot of disciplines in this program And actually, this program also focuses on sustainable development of Arctic natural resources. I would say that Russia is firm in its decision to develop offshore hydrocarbon resources in the Arctic Ocean, and last summer, Rosneft just demonstrated this seriousness by successfully drilling in the Kara Sea and making a significant discovery there, which is called University Discovery. And of course, it was done in cooperation with ExxonMobil, but because of the sanctions and other reasons, the project is delayed and is suspended. But of course, Rosneft will keep doing it alone, but later on, of course, sanctions won't last forever, and there will be some time when they will be lifted up, and of course cooperation in the Arctic, in the development of Arctic resources is inevitable. And another proof to that is that Rosneft has long-standing strategic partnership agreements, not only with ExxonMobil, with Statoil, with Eni, with Total, and several other companies, and there are plans. There have been plans, they are still valid, that jointly with the companies, they will develop Arctic resources in the Kara Sea, in the Siberian Sea, in the Ohotsk Sea, so all the way along the Arctic coastline of the Russian Federation. And of course, another proof that Russia is very serious about the development of Arctic natural resources is that there is a lot of being done to revitalize the Northern Sea Route and to reinforce and develop more the infrastructures which provide navigation along the Northern Sea Route. And of course, another thing is that there is a under construction an LNG plant in Yamal, and of course, Stockman, this issue was raised here. It is on delay now, suspended, but time will come when it will be in production. So all these things are indications of how serious Russia is about the Arctic. And of course, more evidence could be brought up here to prove this, but given the limited time, I won't dwell on that anymore. So but at the same time, when we speak about the future of the cooperation in the Arctic, and of course, from the Russian perspective, we have to speak about the icebound Arctic as compared to our continuous cooperation with Norway in the Barents Sea, which is sub-Arctic, which is free of ice, fortunately. And of course, actually, the first step in setting the stage and paving the road for this cooperation was an agreement on the limitation of the formerly disputable area in the Barents Sea, which was signed a couple of years ago. So this agreement has established a legal framework, a legal base for further cooperation, more productive and specific cooperation between the two countries in the joint production of transboundary resources of that area. Of course, sanctions, they sort of hinder this process, but as I said before, I don't think that they will last forever, and of course there will be some compromise decision in a political nature, but we are talking about the business activities, and of course to meet severe challenges of the Arctic, we need to cooperate. And of course the role of the Arctic Council, which was stressed here, is also very important from the viewpoint of the governance. And we know about the environmental guidelines, which were formulated by the Arctic Council to regulate, which actually are supposed to regulate all types of oil and gas activities in the Arctic. Of course, we understand that the major framework regulatory regime for the Arctic is, of course, the United Nations Convention for International Law of the Sea. But shortly before I came here, I was approached by one of our leading specialists and experts and academic in the area of international law and the law of the sea, is a professor at the Ovalle University, and he said that and he specializes in geographic regulatory regimes, and he also is an advisor for the Foreign Affairs of the Russian Federation. And he just expressed an idea that, of course, the legal regime which is established by the international law of the sea is okay, but it's not sufficient. It is a very broad basis for it, and could incorporate national regulatory regimes, for example, Russian and Norwegian, if they do exist. And so it's if we proceed with developing Arctic resources, we will have to establish somewhat a harmonized regulatory framework regime between Russia and Norway, for example, and maybe with many other neighbors. But still, it should be done, as he views it, on a bilateral basis. So, and we understand that, of course, Arctic, any mega project in the oil and gas sector requires huge investments, and of course, Arctic investments will be much higher than those on the mainland. And of course, Arctic is Arctic resources are attractive from the viewpoint of economic viability because they are big, and the cost of production won't be that much different from the cost of production from the difficult to recover oils and gases on the mainland. So deep water resources, they require a lot of investment. So therefore, time will come when we will have to pass over to the remaining 25% of hydrocarbons which are still undiscovered in the Arctic. So therefore, we have to establish kind of a agreed, unified regulatory regime which would create attractive investment regimes, so that would be taxes, fiscal regimes, which would meet the interests of at least two countries and maybe more. So actually, this is, yes, I'm concluding. So this is the kind of proposal, this is kind of perspective for the future of the governance of the Arctic and the High North. And of course, our universities have to, three universities now, have to pull the forces together and to work in this area, because we have to set the stage for future work for the development of the Arctic resources. Of course, people will say that time is not right now, and it's all for later. But actually, the example, the comparative example of Stockman and Snubbit, because there was first the thought that the technologies which were used for the Snow White Rose project were fit in the Stockman project, which never happened, of course, and a lot of cooperation should be there. And this cooperation should be regulated from all points of view. So therefore, I call upon my present people here to address this issue and to work collectively to achieve a lot in this area. So, to sit down.